In this video, we'll look at the relationship between pressure and volume in gases. Pressure is inversely proportional to volume at constant temperature. So this can be represented by PV, pressure times volume, equals constant K. That means if the volume of a fixed mass of an ideal gas is doubled, the pressure decreases by a half. So next we have an example. What is the new volume of 6 decimeters cubed of gas if the pressure is halved at constant temperature? Well, if you halve the pressure, the volume is doubled. Therefore, the new volume equals 12 decimeters cubed. Next, we look at some graphs of pressure versus volume. So the first one is pressure versus 1 over volume. That's 1 over V. And as you can see, you get a linear graph, which is a straight line. If you plot volume against pressure, then you have a non-linear graph, which is a curve. Next, we look at the relationship between temperature and pressure. Pressure is proportional to absolute temperature, that's the temperature in Kelvin, at constant volume. And this can be represented by P, pressure, over T, temperature, in Kelvin, equals K, constant. So this means that if the pressure of a fixed mass of an ideal gas is doubled at constant volume, the temperature also doubles. If pressure is plotted against temperature in Kelvin, we have a linear graph, a straight line, that passes through the origin. If pressure is plotted against temperature in degrees C, we also have a linear graph. Next, we look at the relationship between temperature and volume. The volume of a gas is proportional to the absolute temperature in Kelvin at constant pressure. And this can be represented by V volume over T temperature equals K constant. If the temperature of a fixed mass of an ideal gas is doubled, the volume also doubles. So let's look at an example. What is the new volume of 10 decimeters cubed of an ideal gas if the temperature is increased from 200K to 400K at constant pressure? So the answer is, if you double the temperature, the volume also doubles, so the new volume is 20 decimeters cubed. And if volume is plotted against temperature in Kelvin, we get a linear graph, which is a straight line. So let's try some examples. What happens to a fixed mass of an ideal gas when the pressure and temperature are both doubled? So the pressure is doubled, so that means the volume is halved. And the temperature is doubled, so the volume is doubled. So we're halving the volume, and then we're doubling the volume, so therefore the volume does not change. So here's one more example. The volume of an ideal gas at 27 degrees C is increased from 3 to 6 decimeters. At what temperature in degrees C will the gas have the original pressure? So the volume is doubled from 3 to 6 decimeters, therefore the pressure is halved. To get back to the original pressure, the temperature can be doubled, because if we double the temperature, we'll double the pressure. So we convert 27 degrees C to Kelvin, and we add 273, so that gives us 300 Kelvin. So we'll double the 300 Kelvin, so that gives us 600 Kelvin, but then we have to convert back to degrees C, because the answer is asking for the temperature in degrees C. So therefore, we subtract 273 from 600, so that gives us a final temperature of 327 degrees C.